كنا بنسافر بخيالنا ونفضل نعافر مع الدنيا في أحلام مليها آخر. كنت بقع كنت بتشديني حاول شوفي كم سنة عشت أنا ودي في مخاطر تفهمينا قبل ما تكلم ده تخاطر أخرس في وصفك بدرس التخاطب مش بهتم لو هعيش بكم في مسامع العالم مش لاقي لوصفك معالم انت العالم فمش بهتم بالدم اللي بيربطني بولاد آدم عن كبرياء أتنازل تبقي أميرة وأنا الخادم وانتي بتحتويني تبقي بيتي فيكي ساكن تايه بتحضنيني بنسى في حضنك الأماكن لما يقولوا لوصفك أنا بفضل أفضل ساكت آسف أنا مين علشان أتغزل فيكي ده انت ما يكفيكي بحر حبر زائد فكر كل من يكتب قصايد دايتوف في وصفك ابن الفارد خليني واضح شوفي كم علاقة باظت بسبب العقل الناضج نفسي انا ارجع مراهق لاجلي مفضل احبك حب صادق خلي من المصالح كحب انت لاجلي لعبة طفل عليها بتصارع قالو الكافر ده تافه وصايع لما قلت اني لو شفت حوا هقول لها ان حبيبتي مش بنتها مهيش بالقيس ولا جوليت ولا هي عقلة ولا انا عنطرة دي مش من البشر دي القمر بيغير منها تسألوني عن اسمها قول البحر في ساعة صفا تسألوني عن حسنها خاف اقول دي من الملايكة فكون ظلمتها تهديني لديني فبشوف القبلة في وشها دي نص ديني يكمل ايماني في حضنها انا لو ايماني في حضن غيرها فانا كافر بغير حبها
يا كلمة بتتقال في كلام وسط الموال يا
Hola amigos, welcome back to another episode of Futures Edge. We are on the Landstrider server and this is hosted by Aim to Game. I'm right here guys in top of this windmill. I put four of them but each of them they're not really good actually. Each of them give almost 37 at this level. Are a fatigue unless there is a thunderstorm. That will give you almost 50. Unfortunately, in multiplayer, I don't know why crafting the engineering voltmeter doesn't work. It crashed my client every time I tried to do that, but I tested it out in a creative world. So you can have a really nice look in the base here. I started to put overrun. I'm gonna put that kind of wood instead of concrete. I think it's gonna look a little bit better. And all that island in there in the middle, I think I'm gonna get rid of and maybe use to do something in there. I love how the river goes through it. So maybe we can put windmills all around the river. Water mills. Anyway. This is what I have in here. Let me go down. These are treated wood scaffolding, so you can go up and down. But also you can jump, since that's why I put it on the in the water here. And I hope I reach the water. There you go. And right here, let me show you a few of the changes I've made. I have an exit right here in the water with scaffolding. This is go all the way down. This is under the bridge. In here we have the water mills is coming. You can see from there actually. Let me show you. Yeah, this is the access to the water mill. So over there is connected right here. Everything is connected around. And goes all the way here to my capacitor banks. And in here is where, a lag. Oh man, lags by the way, kill me one time. Oh, come on. All right, there you go. So this is the capacitor bank. Is input one and one is just because I'm using one and that one is actually this in here, the powered lantern. The way I connected everything, so it's coming from there in one entry. Let me actually show you here. So if I remove this and this, you can actually see right there. This is the entry on this one, and on the bottom is coming from the water mills. So once you put the cable, by the way, you can actually close and the cable will stay okay. So this is the output going to that power lantern. The power lantern, by the way, give a little bit more light than the regular lanterns, but also it prevents spawning in 64 radius, I think it is, or 32 or 64, don't quote me on that. So this is connected to this in here. Actually, I think it's gonna look better. Let me actually go up. Oops. Oh, come on. I cannot go up like this. Okay, let me actually remove these. Okay, and I think I'm gonna just remove that and connect it straight like this. I think it's gonna look a little better. So let's connect that one to this one in here. Okay. And I want to connect another one right here. And I think it's gonna look good if I connect it straight to here, maybe right over here. Let's see, we can put it right here. Let me actually grab something like that so it doesn't float in the air. And in here I can put another LV wire connector. Come on. Go almost there, so one in there, and we can hook up that one to that one over there. There you go. So we go this way, and I think I better eat something because if not, I'm gonna die. So let's go in here, grab something to eat from there. Okay, so this is gonna be a mess. Oh, by the way, we have two new dogs, Laika and Paul. If you know where I came up with those names, write down in the comments why are these two dogs frame or four. And you will have the opportunity, if you you're the first and you got it right, to name my two horses. All right, so I want to connect everything in here. And let me show you this. I'm organizing a little bit in here. So what I have is I put a bunch of more these frame drawers. I put the controller right here. I put these wooden storage crates just because I can touch the ceiling and it's not a chest. So I put some in there for blood magic and from chisels and beads. And all this is connected, by the way, coming from here using these frame trims, so that way I can connect all these to all that because it's connected directly. So if I grab, for example, let me for example grab all the obsidian here, so we have zero obsidian right now, and I put everything in there, it will go straight there. You can see now we have 19 obsidians in there, so everything is connected because of that. But also I'm gonna bring power from this in here, so power is gonna come from this LV capacitor that I want to hook up over there with a cable. Probably it's not the most efficient way to do it, but I think it's gonna look cool. So that's why I have another wooden post, and this one we're gonna put as well in this in here. Let's why cannot put that in there? Oh, okay, that's why. That's inventory tweaks, I think. And also I lost my oak wood. Okay, let's put that one in there. That one in there. Okay, and I'm gonna, this time I gonna put it like this so I can hook up that one like so. And let's connect actually that cable. Let's see, let's go up in here, gonna hook up that one to this one in here, boom. And then I'm gonna need another cable. I have a bunch of materials here to do other stuff. I'm gonna show you how I build that as well. But let's hook up now this one in here. That one, I'm gonna hook it up straight to this one. There you go. So it's coming here, and that is gonna provide power to these machines in here. They're already full, but if I put something in there, you will see. Now, I want to close all these, and I think I left everything in here. Do I have more of these? Where did I put all my oak wood? Let's double check. Probably is in here. Okay, so I'm gonna close that. I should probably put some torches just in case. Now I reorganize everything. Oh, this is not opening. Okay, it's because of that. Okay, I'm gonna have to fix that. Yeah, this is not open because of that. Oh man, these do open because this doesn't count as a full block. And I think I have, oh, that's just a piece of wood. Let me just get rid of that. Okay, but for now, these in here we can actually close, so it looks better. And I think I'm gonna close it like this. We can remove that and this, and that actually I can close it as well, like so. Very nice. So it's going through that. Let me double check on the top there. Okay, yeah, I can even put one of these in there like so. Very nice. Let's test it out and see if it's the power is coming. I have some materials in here, so let's put some iron to cook in there. The idea is that I will throw it in here. It's gonna go straight to this. It's gonna cook, go this way. As soon as it's done, it's gonna go through this to my drawer controller, and we should see my iron in there going up. Let's see if that's the case. Yeah, there you go. So it's working perfectly. And now we can close this, I think. Now that it's all done, it's gonna look really nice. This one, like so. Also, that in there. Perfect. So now I have to move that around. I'm gonna have to remove this chest. I think I prefer to work in like this than using the chest. Or I can put a chest and just put a half slab, top half slab in there. But as you can see, even if I put, if I have a block in there, you will see it doesn't look like this and this and this is connected. But everything it is connected using only these frame trims. So that's going to look good. All right. So, and by the way, when that light over there is turned off, it means I'm using more power than actually I'm using. So let's say, for example, I throw a bunch of these in here. Let's throw copper right there. So now you see, I'm gonna, let's go check out and see the light in there. That's why I'm not sleepy. I want to you to see. Okay, input 122, output 124. Okay, so I'm not using more than I'm producing actually right now, so that's okay for now. But probably as soon as I start using the bees and stuff, I'm gonna start producing a lot more. So I can throw, when I come from mining, I can throw the tin, iron. I have some gold in here, so I can throw everything in here, and that's gonna start working out and doing his stuff. Very cool. What else I wanted to show you in here? Oh, I have in here my dark boots and dark boot, dark armor, dark steel armor. So I craft already. This one already put. It's empowered. I put the glider. And The rest is not empowered, and I think I have some empowerment right here from a quest, so we're gonna do that. This is my enchanting room, and I have a bunch, few anvils that I actually took from mobs, so we're gonna empower this boot. That means that we can now charge them. There you go, we can empower this one, and I'm gonna empower this as well. Now let's go to our machinery room. I maybe have gonna have another capacitor just to charge these, but we can charge these three stuff in here. This one also, let's finish it up. I think it's already charged. Because this armor is getting damaged, and I don't want to damage all of it right now, so let's use that. Now I have a new armor, a Darksteel armor, and what's good, oh, this one, of course, I cannot jump, so that's something that I need to put. Let's put jump, piston plus 4 level. Yeah, let's do that. I want to put speed, actually, as well. Jump, flippers. I know. Let's see. Speed. Potion of Swiftnet plus 4 levels. So, gonna have to get used to that until I do a potion of Swiftnet. But we can make a piston. So, let's make a piston with some of these, some of these, some of these. Actually, I don't remember how to make a piston, but I think I need some planks also. Yes. I do have some planks. Okay, let's make one piston. I'm missing one. There you go. All right, so now we can put the jump boost also in there. So let's put a jump boost right here. Okay, on the boots. Very nice. Now we should be able to jump a fence. Yeah, there you go. Okay, perfect. So at least we have that. And yeah, in the meantime, we can put this away for now. So we can throw in there. There you go. So we have that armor. What else I have in here? I have a bunch of stuff because I've been doing a lot of stuff at the same time. Oh, I still have one frame that I need to put somewhere. Oh, probably is the one I removed from there. So there you go. I have that one in there. This one in here. Oh, there's a bunch of stuff I want to talk to you about. This, what I have in here. So this is the alchemical bag that was given to me by Dornal. So thank you very much, Dornal. You can craft it like so. You need this that is coal and diamond, and also wool and reinforced storage crate. But it's huge. Look at the size of this thing. And I've been doing this staff just for the fun of it. They're not very powerful, but they're cool to watch. These in here are, look how cool. You can throw fire with that one. You can throw this kind of fire with this one, and I can throw the other one like that. This one is actually, whoa, stop it. I don't know what happened there. Normally it should be one. There you go. But yeah, all those are crafted with the drop from the Lycanthids mobs, so that's really nice. There's still a bunch of scepters that you can craft. You can see in here, no, not those one, but most of the drops from those kind of mobs, like for example this one, it's gonna give you another one. This in here also, for example, you have another one. So there's a bunch of stuff you can make in there. I make also the soul stone. This, we're gonna use it as soon as we can to make the, oh man, I need to, if I jump it's faster, but I need to put that potion of swiftness. Let me show you in here something. This was Lance Strider's idea. Look how cool it looks. The papaya, pearl, plum, and banana on the same tree. This is really something good. And I'm doing that with the moving one. So let's say I have here the plum. And I want to put also, let's put, for example, this one in there. Let me just remove the fruits itself just to show you. But I can take that one out and put it here. Actually, I'm going to put it right there so I can craft it, grab from one place and put it in there. How cool is that? So I can put on the same tree a bunch of different fruits, and I think this one I'm gonna move it. I'm gonna put it a little bit higher so all are in the same level, but I think this is gonna look really nice, probably like that. I'm gonna put it probably like this on this like an arrow. No, actually that one is okay like that. Yeah, I'm gonna put it like that so you can see it from here and see the different trees. I think that's gonna look very nice. All right, what else? I wanted to show you also what I've been doing with, let me put this away. How do I use the builder block? I haven't showed that, I think. Well, I'll show it in other series, but not in this one. So let's say I go right there and I want to start removing all that mountain. So one way, of course, is to make it manually. Can I jump three? No, I only can jump two with this. Okay, unless I put maybe another jump two. Piston plus six more levels give me jump two. Maybe I will put that one. It's kind of nice to jump three. So if I want to remove these, for example, so let me just go in here, just show you a test. So let's put the builder right here. There's something around, I don't know. Anyway, let's put the builder in here. I have in here a bunch of cards that I crafted as well. Let me just put these away for now. There you go. I'm gonna need the lever. I'm gonna need the Stirling generator as well. And there was a bunch of stuff that I wanted to make. I think there's someone inside. Yeah, somebody. I'm out from the Nether. Trap it there. Anyway, so let's take a look at this. This is the builder. You can build stuff using materials. So do I have a crate in here? Wooden storage crate, yes I do. Okay, let's put a wooden storage crate on top. There's nothing in it. And first thing I want to show you is how these three work. So let's start with the query. So if I shift right click the query here, it will select the query, and then I need to tell it where to query. So let's say I want to query from this in here to, I'm just going to do it something small for now, because normally we're not going to be able to see anything. It will replace the dirt, so you're not going to really see what it's doing, but you will see that transform to dirt actually. So if I right click on this, blocks that is going to take away are 375. It's going to replace them with dirt. And you will see it's a solid box that I want to make in here. So it's a solid box that he's going to take a look and see if he can get something from there. And we can offset this and change the dimension, so make it bigger. I'll show that how it works when I do the shape actually. So let's throw that in there. We can take a look on how it's going to look. These actually are the preview mode. And let's put a lever right here. Remember the crate is empty. And there you go. You'll see it working. It's already finished. It used a little bit of power. That's why I normally use the stirring generator. But we can switch it off, and you will see all the materials that it took from that flat mushroom, some bamboo shots, and a bunch of cobblestone and dirt. And all that is now dirt. Okay? But if we go deeper, of course, it's gonna make more sense on the mining, actually. So, and what's good about those crates is that you can take them away and you keep all the inventory. But actually, let me show you that a little better if we go, because I'm curious to see what the hell is trapped in there. Oh, one of the pinky ones. No wonder, my friend. Stop making noise. Let's go actually down here in the mine. I think that's gonna, this is gonna be a better example. So let's put it in here. So I'm gonna put it right there. Gonna take the quarry. Okay. And I'm gonna mark, actually, let me open that a little bit so we can see a little better. So let's mark, for example, this in here. Actually, shift right click on that one, mark this in here, and I'm gonna go in one direction, okay, and in another direction, and I'm gonna mark this block in there. Boom. Okay, just for a little demonstration here. So if I only mark that, I'm not gonna change of course the values here, just to show you with that. So if I go like this, I put in there, I put the lever there, and let's put the storage crate in here. Just gonna remove that, and let's turn it on. There you go, we got some cobblestone, marble, limestone, and more cobblestone. So, I can tell it, if I grab it now, I can tell it to void cobblestone, dirt, all these in here. I want to void everything. And I'm going to offset the dimension of the Y level. I'm going to put it to 26. So, it's going to go down a lot. And let's use it like that and see what happens. Look at this. So it's grabbing for me a bunch of copper, iron, more marble, and that's it. But all the way down, you will see it will be all dirt. So that's really nice. I love this machine in here. Okay, so I show you how to use that one. Now, let's say I want to do the, exactly the same, but what I want is actually to void that. So I'm going to select from here. Let's grab this one here, shift right click, and from these two, let me go in here and mark that one in there just to show you. And let's go up. I can always change the value in here, but I'm not gonna. And now the only thing we're gonna do is to void everything that is in there. So there you go. I don't know why that glitch sometimes. Oh, probably is because in here I have a box instead of a solid box. So that's why it's doing that. So let's do it again. There you go. So we have a void, and this is very nice to clear a room, for example this mountain, if I don't want the materials back, of course. And finally we have the shape card. So let's do something like that. So let's see, I want I don't know, I want something in here. So let me put, actually, let me put something like that, and we'll just do a test in here with that shape guard. So imagine I want I mark this one and mark the first and the last. Now let's remove whatever we have in here. Okay, I'm just gonna jump right there. And in here I'm gonna tell it to do, I don't know, Taurus. Sounds good. So I'm gonna put in there, put the shape that I want. And in here, of course, I'm gonna need to tell him what's the material that it's gonna use. So whatever I put in there, let's put marble, that's the material I want to use for the torus. So there you go, I have a nice little shape on that. So this machine is really something very nice to use, not only to mine, but also to build, and it may save you a lot of time. So let's go back up. And I think we're running out of time, guys. So let me double check that if that's the case. I need to put some doors in here. Actually, before we go, I want to show you something else as well. So let me put that back in here. Anyway, I wanted to mention this in here. This is, that was a crate that I was using before. This is what I use to make a bunch of stuff, including some of these cables, wires. So let me show you. And actually, let me show you how I put it together. But it's quite easy. Now, before I do that, remember to remove your this in here. I don't know why I lost one doing removing everything without removing that. So I'm gonna take out this, and I'm gonna take out all these as well. Okay, because I'm gonna actually put it right here, so it can go straight to my chest. Actually, maybe it would be a good idea to put it over here. I don't know, that I think I'm running out of space, and I don't want to just build something very big with all the machines. So at one point I think I'm gonna put the machines elsewhere, but for now let's put it right here. I'm gonna put if I put it out here, I'm gonna block my view, so I'm gonna put it right here for now. So let's put one in there, one in there, one there. I'm gonna put the piston there and the heavy engineering block right there. And I need to put something going this way and the other one. I love this new, this is new, but for example, the arrows was not in the previous version, because now you can put it exactly where you want it to look. Before, you had to put it and move it around till it came to place. So let me also move around this, and now I can right click, I think, boom, and there you go, we have that in there. I can use a hopper, for example, if I put it in there, to put the copper in there. It's gonna throw it as soon as it has some power. So luckily we have some power over there. Let's see if we can reach that. Let's see, where did I put? I think I put everything in my bag, right? Yeah, I have LV wires, but I'm gonna need some connectors as well. LV connectors and LV connectors. Okay, so let me see if I can. Can I jump there? No, now I cannot. Gonna need. Okay. Let's see if we can hook up this LV wire from this to this in here. Yeah, perfect. Okay. So that should start working. Copper. Oh, okay. I need to put a press. So if I put a press right there, boom, now it should start working. And what I can do is put this crate in here, and then put a drop in like that, so it goes straight to that whenever I put a material there. So let's see, do I have something else? No, let's put a little bit more copper, because wires is something that you never have enough. You never have enough. So now we can come in here, throw it in there, and you will see it going right there. Very nice. And this is, by the way, the best use of the press for the wire at the beginning, because if not, you're gonna be doing a lot of using a lot of copper. So very cool. At least now we have that, and I love that now in immersive engineering we have the conveyor belt that is this one, vertical conveyor belt. So I can actually come here and continue going straight to this, or just use some conduits to bring everything from here to my base. I think that's what I'm gonna do, actually, instead of throwing any conveyor belts. But anyway, guys, that's a lot episode. I hope you enjoy it. It's been fun. I'm gonna definitely put some speed on this, because it's crazy. And by the way, now that we have that, let me show you that now we have jump. We have the glider. So I think that's going to be the best way to finish this episode. If I go all the way up. All right, guys. So that's going to be it. I have the glider on. And let's just go flying.
Stupid kicks made by Gucci, Gucci. Shades on my face by Gucci, Gucci. Shirt on my back by Gucci, Gucci. Shorts by Gucci, hat by Gucci. Stupid kicks made by Gucci, Gucci. Shades on my face by Gucci.